And what the drivers say they fear most of all is a head-on collision with a blind tube mare.
Personally, I think the management should round them up. Get rid of them.
What's up, YouTube? Last bit, Jim Jefferies. I think this is going to be really short because I haven't timed it very well, as per usual. So God knows it could be like 30 seconds and then it ends. But, you know, whatever. It's still going to be good. Right, let's just literally dive right in. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Me, not Jim Jefferies. And I'll see you on the other side. So let's dive right in.
So I said to the girls, I said, you can go home. And the big girl went, but I still want to get fucked. And I went, you're more of a package deal. Now, as soon as I said it, I felt like a fucking asshole, right? One of the great things about being an offensive comic is you can cover your steps very quickly by going, I'm kidding. I'm crazy. So I did that. I went, I'd love to fuck you. I love you. I was kidding. I'd love it. But I can't fuck you in front of your friend. And she points at a friend and goes, you get in the bathroom while I fuck him. And I went, I can't see why that wouldn't work. Now I've got to fuck, it'd be rude not to. You can't be willing to fuck someone in a couple and not be willing to fuck them as an individual. That's bad manners, and my mother brought me up better than that. So I'm going to fuck this girl, to be polite. And her friend didn't want to go into the bathroom, and she's like crying, and her friend's like pushing her, like, just get in the fucking bathroom. This big fat girl's pushing this hot girl, like, get in the fucking bathroom. And I'm so wasted, I'm getting involved, like, yeah, get in the bathroom. And so we push this hot girl into the bathroom. She sits on the toilet, she's crying, she's so hot, and she's crying, like, Then she turns her hairdryer on so she doesn't have to listen. So picture, like, there's this hot girl, she's crying, she's holding her hairdryer, just, Anyway, that gave me an erection. So now I've got an erection. Big question. Do I wear a condom? And the answer is no. I was on too many drugs to come. No one's getting fucking pregnant. And let's be honest, 18-year-old Canadian who'd never seen cocaine, let's go out on a limb and say she doesn't have AIDS. And even if she did have AIDS, it wouldn't be the aggressive AIDS. It would be a soft, gentle, girly AIDS that probably wouldn't kill me. So I got on top of her. I thought it was a premature ejaculator, so I didn't have to fuck it for too long. Because I knew I wasn't going to come, right? So I put my cock in it for like 10 thrusts. I went, and I just pulled out and went, And she went, what was that? And I went, I just came over there. And she goes, no, you didn't. I went, yes, I did. There's heaps of it over there. I wouldn't go over there, you'll get pregnant. It looks like a Jackson Pollock painting over there. Anyway, then we let a friend out of the bathroom. The girls got dressed and they went home. Now that should be the end of the story, but it's not. That story happened 5 years ago. Now this year, I went back to Just for Laughs Comedy Festival in Montreal, and I wasn't supporting some movie star. I was in the big theater myself, and when I finished the show, I went to the stage door and there was people waiting for my autograph, and at the end of the queue was the hot girl all of these years later. And I took her back to my hotel and I fucked her. Now, the reason I tell you this story is because you should never give up on your dreams. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much. Good night. Bye-bye.
Well, what an anticlimax. That was all of, 2 minutes? Sorry about that. This is why people watch TV, I suppose, because it's thought out and done by professionals. Anyway, Jim Jefferies, fully functional, brilliant, it was too. And don't anybody go nowhere.